Hi guys, Follow welcome back to this Sonic Adventure 2 Battle Quickplay. For those of you just joining us, basically what's a Quickplay? It's kind of somewhere between a Let's Play and a Speedrun. It's kind of a half and half battle, average between the two. So we're going to monster through it, but we're not going to be skipping content.
I'm Knuckles the Echidna. Just call me Knuckles. Following a faint signal I was getting from the Master Emerald, I found myself in this coral canyon. Sure feels creepy. But I'm not afraid of ghosts. I have to find the pieces of the Master Emerald now.
Well, we better get to it then. Really like his levels.
There's no time to lose. I have to hurry and find the Master Emerald.
I don't have the fluidness that Sonic's levels have, but they're a lot of fun. An enemy, eh? Hold that.
It's close. Two more left. All right.
Quite large. I mean, this one's really open, but some of them are really intricate. So you end up missing a lot of them because of how quickly you're sort of plowing ahead, trying to find the emeralds, get it done. But there's actually a lot to. Camera resetting is really getting on my nerves.
Options.
Okay, so I can't. Give me a good position to jump up front. Place where books. We'll take it. Place where flames cross. Yeah, let's take that chow key.
It's closer. All right.
That was a pain in the ass level. I don't know what the hell was going on with the camera back and forth, but I kept sort of resetting it to look at my character.
Yeah, I feel good.
I don't feel I deserve a B. I feel I got screwed over by the camera. I mean, how the hell can you play Knuckles?
Citizens of Earth, lend me your ears and listen to me very carefully. My name is Dr. Eggman, the world's greatest scientist, and soon to be the world's greatest ruler. Now witness the beginning of the greatest empire of all time.
Eggman loves his orbital satellite. Well, that's not good. I mean, man, we like the moon. Oh yeah, and Tails just happens to have a Chaos Emerald.
They have the power to attract each other. I can use that to find where Eggman is.
And we never thought of this in previous games.
Put your hands up in the air and get off the ground!
I'll take care of the police while you try and find a way out of here. Find Eggman!
Got it!
Again, we're fighting. Can't we just explain? Look, there are more than one hedgehog on the planet. The other guy's black, I'm blue. Although, Arrest the Black Guy kind of sounds a bit racist. Get the hover. So much better with the hover. When you get in an awkward position on the edge of a platform, you can sort of hover to twist around.
Thank you.
gold enemy too. Get the extra points. I don't think it's even possible to S rank most of the levels without certain power-ups, so I'm not particularly worried about getting the highest rank possible, just as long as we see some reasonable progression. Charwell. And again, as I've been doing, I'm gonna go straight in, feed my chow, and then eat.
Here.
Navy gorilla. Well, they reduced his flight. What? Gorillas can't fly? Although he now has an epic monobrow. Never decide which I prefer to give it. I mean, animals are certainly much more interesting to give, and they give much more stats, but they also have the potential to have negative effects. Let's be doing that and leave, because we have to get back to the story mode and plow through it.
Inside the mines to be like this. This is gonna be tougher than I thought. It's closer.
Annoying ones where you have to like find your way through tunnels. Somewhere behind the wall that you have to drop down one of these shafts to get to. Yeah.
It's closer.
I was expecting some sort of really like awkward solution on how we're getting out of there. I'm going to drop down and see whether the emerald's near the pot. Okay, no, so we need to climb out the top. What making S rank in Knuckles levels is really awkward, because it's not just a matter of do you know how to find the emerald efficiently. Sometimes it's a matter of just got lucky. I feel like I have to get a spring to get that.
Yeah.
kind of screwed that up by pressing glide just after I landed on the spring. Okay, maybe not. Maybe it's the water level. Is this one of the ones where I have to raise the water? I honestly don't remember where I'm supposed to go to get up there now. Ah, of course. I raised in the mid platform, it lets you just jump to it. And not here. Great. See, this emerald is just a case of. I don't really know my way around at the moment that well. There's gonna be a tunnel somewhere that I've gotta walk down to even get near it. Perhaps it's one of the ones that you have to set the water. Maybe we have to set the water to the mid level.
Different areas are accessible depending on the water levels.
A hint, so pretty much guaranteed no SO. Down below. You're pushing helpful.
If you throw the switch, the water level might change. So try it!
Basically the way it goes is those platforms that were at the bottom of floatable and they can block your access. So you have to get them to float above where you want to go down to get access. It's really annoying as most Sonic underwater levels are. I hate it. Big? Big, what are you doing here, man? I have a feeling I'm not going to be able to get Big. I missed that. So let's pause. Down below. Underwater path behind caution sign that warns about the ghosts. Caution ghosts. But I've already been there. There was no ping. Okay, so this is the one I've been down. I need the water back down. So the third switch. Totally forgot there was more than one of those. There's one. And there's the other. The one where Big is. Oh my god. I don't want to explore down there, but I'm probably going to drown.
I found him.
This is why I also kind of thought it wasn't...
I have to try harder.
Wasn't really good idea to do a proper speedrun. It's like, it's so long since I played this game, I'm kind of going in blind. There's things like that you learn in a playthrough that save you a lot of time. So, straight in. Drop off the stuff, straight back out. Easy in, easy out.
Now there.
Came off. Knuckles gotta be the guy to encourage power, right? So naturally we are encouraging mostly swim on. At least I know I've got a good, pretty good chance of doing well at the first like beginner level swimming races now.
Sheesh, there always seems to be a lot of police around when you don't need them. Tails, any news yet?
For some reason, I'm not getting a signal from the six remaining Chaos Emeralds. Maybe Eggman took the emeralds into outer space.
Outer space?
Yes, because it's easier to detect an emerald through the planet than from directly above you.
Hey guys, long time no see. I must have got lost in the mines. Looking for the Master Emerald pieces was tougher than I thought it would be. Where are we anyway?
Hey, where are you going?
Move aside, Knuckles!
I managed to find the transcripts between Eggman and the President in the government computer. I'm calling the President's limo right now!
So, hacking the government computer.
If we get into the limo, we can trace the call to find Eggman.
Okay, let's meet up there.
I love how Tails just casually hacks the... Just casually hacks the government's computer. Chase the president.
The president must be over there. Let's go.
Okay. I really like this level. It's a nice change. Something I really love about Sonic Adventure 2. It gives you a nice... It gives you a nice balance of... of like, the really fast-paced, like, classic Sonic levels and some variety.
Getting closer.
That looked like the limit. Was I supposed to like collide with that? I really think maybe I should have collided into that vehicle. It looks like a limo.
Tails, did you find the president?
Almost, Sonic. Just a few more minutes.
We don't have minutes. Eggman's gonna blow up the world. Make Eggman Land. I don't want to go to Eggman Land. The prices will probably be terrible. Scientist in charge of the world sounds like a good idea, but those guys are geniuses in their field. They have no common sense. And again, most politicians got plenty of common sense, but complete morons. On balance, I'd probably trust Eggman to run the world more than I would trust most politicians.
Yeah, I found the president.
Yeah, I found him, and he's got what looks like a bullet mark on his window. Or maybe a couple of sword slashes. Not Eggman's style. You just blow him up. Kart racing with 3 courses now available.
Mr. President, reports show that since the incident 3 hours ago, the country is in turmoil. Our financial communities are impacted, and our satellite communications are down. An emergency meeting has been called. Mr. President, this is a national crisis.
Spare me the details. Exactly just what is it that you want? Dr. Eggman.
Well, let's just get down to business then, shall we, Mr. President? I won't bore you with all the details since I know you are a very busy man. Mr. President, my demands are quite simple. Surrender to the Eggman Empire and make no attempts to resist. Otherwise, your country will cease to exist. You have 24 hours to give me your answer.
No way!
What the?
Sonic!
Eggman Empire! Yeah, right!
What the heck's going on here?
Don't worry,
no.
Mr. President.
What did you
Everything's
do?
Everything's under control. Just leave it to us. Got it, Tails?
I got it! He's transmitting from the space colony Ark!
Okay, let's move it!
So all the power and resources available to the president.
We're receiving an incoming signal from our agent.
All the power of the president and resources, and
inside that pyramid,
tells the Sonic do his job just in 10 seconds.
And more importantly, I saw that Batgirl go inside with him as well. Well, you saw them too, right?
Well, yeah.
You should be able to get into outer space from there. I don't know what this space colony is all about, but I'll find and destroy that cannon, and then kick their imperial butts.
All right.
I'll go and find the entrance.
Let's go! Let's go! Locking onto his wallet, god damn it! Kind of off the cards now I've died, but combos more than speed is more important for Tails. Don't forget an S rank. Not to say speed is not important, but it's just combos are more important. Okay. I love the elves, man. They're really inventive. Die, spiky bastard. Awesome. This is probably going to only be a D rank because of the death. But... oh, B!
Very good!
Okay. I would say that's possibly one of the levels you can S rank without without the power-ups. Well, obviously you need the hover. You need the hover to progress in the game, so that one doesn't count. Really need to name this chow. One more level, I think. My little army of tigers. Eat a bear. Eat a bear. I should probably feed it the skunk first, because I don't like...
everything will be okay.
I don't like it looking like a skunk. I want the stats, but I don't like it looking like a skunk. I like certain elements of the penguin. You are my dark chow. Why are you You can get out of the way. I don't need a dark chow right now. Heroes don't talk to dark chows. Oh, that takes a lot of fire. Okay, that'll do. I'm not spending ages going back and forth. If I remember rightly, this has some really cool ways you can like run on the wall, but they're a little bit buggy. God damn it. I keep trying to light speed dash. Ooh, that camera. The camera swing nearly killed me then. Let's get the chow. Bounce bracelet. Oh, I love this one. This is the one that lets you go back to the first level and unlock extra things.
Ouch!
Back with them enemies to Sonic Adventure 1. They're quite like the E105 series. Okay, press the button and away we go.
This door looks different from others. It may open if you put something here.
Goddamn ghosts! Ghost! Okay, I got the points for that, but... Just... There we go, light speed dash works for a change! I don't remember this being so buggy when I first played it. There we go.
Yes!
Barely made it.
Yep, I deserve that. Totally fucked up. Okay, I think we're going to call it there. We'll do a little bit of chow raising. So if you don't care about chows, just like previously, you know, won't be offended. Feel free to leave. Now we're going to go and make little baby chows fight each other for our entertainment. Level 7s?
Don't worry, buddy.
Level 7 swim? Already? It's actually doing quite well. I'm going to feed in the sheep first because I don't like the aesthetics of the sheep. I bet there's some players out there coming up with like really complicated strategies on the order you feed animals in order to maximise the output. Not me. I like the peacock feathers. So he's getting the peacock last. Don't like the bat, but I'm not going to waste it. Oh, he's crying. Why are you crying, little buddy?
Don't worry, buddy. Don't worry, buddy.
Is that because he didn't want to eat a bat? Get out of my way. Okay, now. What I think was happened last time when it sort of moved me on to the next level is... when you leave the chow garden... it moves you on to just progressing the story. With the whole idea that you enter the Chow Garden with a key from the story and then like, no more key, continue. So we have to do, like, stage select to be able to, like, wander in and out, I think. So we're going to go grab our Chow and we're going to try naming him. I think, I've not bothered looking it up, but I'm sure there's some sort of naming at the school or the black market or some other bullshit like that. So where's our chow? Okay. Hey little buddy, you really need to work on your stamina. It is terrible. Man, that's slow. Here we go. Right. Off to the Chow's kindergarten. Right, principal. Bulletin board. Message. This is the Chow kindergarten. You can ask for detailed tips from the kindergarten principal. You can talk to various Chow experts as well. Fortune teller. Welcome to the fortune teller house. You won't get your fortune told here, but it's fun to get a nice name for your chow. It will give your chow a lucky name. Oh, your chow is a newborn. I will give your chow a good name. This chow's lucky name is... summoning the powers to be Presto. How about Rusty? No. Really, you don't like this name? Do you want a different name? Yes. Okay, I'll try again. Lucky name is summoning the powers to be Presto. How about No! How about naming the chow yourself? Yes. We're gonna call him What can we... you know, I hadn't even planned a name. I had a name in my last episode, but I can't remember it now. Okay. Nice to this child, so I'm not gonna name it something horrible. Just thinking randomly, the first name that comes into my head. We may come back and rename the child later. I hope Fred will become a good child. And I get an achievement! Okay, Health Center. Health Center. This is the health center. You've got to examine your child. See the doctor. This is not good. Your child is very... What? No way this can't be. Your child is very healthy. This is not good. Health results. Okay, so... his ability. I think the way the ability works is... That's your child's growth. When you give it stuff, or the chance of growth, or maybe it's its maximum, something like that. So you can raise any child to have high stats in any area, but if you want to do the really challenging, like child races and stuff, you need one that's got both high ability and you've spent time farming stats, something like that. Anyway, what else we got? Principal. Welcome to the channel, I'm the kindergarten principal. Learn tips to raise your child from Professor Chow. Yeah, sure. Actually, I'm the child doctor. What was your... What? Okay, can't we get a principal? Don't we have the budget for a principal and a doctor? What's a chow? Chow are small, cute, and mysterious creatures to live in the chow garden. Everyone loves chow. If you go to the chow garden, you can raise your own chow. Getting into the chow garden, you need... Well, yeah, we hadn't worked that out by being here. Key is hidden in each access stage, try finding it. The eggs in the garden are chow eggs. They will hatch by themselves, but you're going to help it hatch by holding it. Your child's personality will change depending on how the egg is hatched. Basically, if you throw it in a wall, it will be mean. If you cuddle it, it will be nice. If you leave it, it will be kind of neutral. Chow love to eat tree fruit. Can chow grow healthy by eating tree fruit? You can find fruits in trees in the garden. Press B button to grab a tree and use left stick to shake it. Fruits will fall to the ground. Have you seen the small animals? Yes, I have. Small animals are hidden in action stages. No shit. Give the animals to chow and watch them change or learn special abilities. Ah, I didn't know the special abilities. Besides small animals, there are chaos drives in the action stages. Give them to your chow and they will change. Depending on what kind of animals are called the chaos drives, give them, they will change. Try all kinds of combinations. So I'm guessing, I don't remember the special abilities, but I'm guessing if you like get certain combinations of animals, or you go like full on like peacock or full on unicorn, maybe it will give it an ability from that animal or something? I don't know. I don't remember ever getting special abilities, so we'll see. Okay, there are three different chow gardens. Ooh, chow got different in each garden. At first, only one garden is open. To get the other two gardens, there are some special requirements. Have you seen all three gardens? No, I have not. Chow love to be held or petted. Only pet your chow when it's good, and don't spoil your chow, or it may turn out to be naughty. Sometimes spoiled rotten chow are still cute, though. So this is basically just saying, do whatever the hell you want, guys. You don't need to be a responsible chow owner. But let's be fair, it's a digital pet. You could throw it against the wall every day and abuse it. It doesn't mean you're going to be a bad parent. You're able to tell it's mating season when you see flowers blooming around your chow. Mate them and they may lay eggs, which is how you kind of get... I don't know how the mechanics... I don't remember how the mechanics of it work. I'll have to look it up. But basically, it's how you get Chao with the higher, stat ratings. Chao loved to eat tree fruits. There are different fruits. Try them and see which fruits are best. Chao gains stamina when they eat tree fruits. Chao's chances of winning Chao races and karate increase when they have more stamina. There are two different types of trees in the Chao Garden. One grows in the garden and never dies. Other types of tree grow from the seeds that you can buy in the black market. These trees grow and will later die. So basically you get this common, really basic one stamina bar fruit. And those will just grow continually in the garden. Then you get these other ones that have other effects, which we'll look at in a minute. The will only grow once. I think you get, if you shake the fruit off at the right timing, I think you get 6 fruit out of each one, maybe 9. Because they grow it, I think they grow in sets of 3, and if you can knock them off the tree at the right time to get the maximum effect, get the maximum efficiency out of the tree, I think it's 9. Might be wrong. How to plant seeds? Well, that's a secret. You're useful. You can plant up to 7 trees in each garden. You will not be able to plant any seeds after 7 trees are grown in the garden. Mysteriously, time passes only when you are in the garden. Therefore, you can raise your Chao at your own pace in each garden. Even if you have more than one garden to take care of. So basically, you can neglect your Chao for as long as you like. Your Chao can learn many skills, which can be checked. Remember, the higher your Chao skill rating, the greater your chance of winning Chao races or karate. Your Chao's level increases when you give them small animals and chaos drives. When Chao levels up, its skills increase. Also, when it said skills earlier, it just meant it's different abilities. Give the its different stats. Give blah blah. Each Chao's skill increases in is different even when the same animals and chaos drive. The reason is that the skill increase of each Chao based on their ability. You can check the Chao's ability by reading its medical chart at the health center. Each Chao has its own potential for ability. Blah 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 blah. The higher the ability ranking, the greater the increase in skill. Each Chao is born with its own ability ranking, but there are also other ways to increase it. Okay, enough reading now. We'll come back later. Let's see what we have at, I think this is, we can leave the Chao to do certain lessons, but we're not going to do that now. Because I want my Chao fighting! You can buy items with my rings. We can sell items? You don't have anything to sell, okay? Shopping, okay. So, basically, hero fruit. Hero fruit will make your Chao more into a hero, Sonic, Tails, Knuckles, it will make it the good Chao to go in the good garden. Strong seed, round seed, apple, mushroom, very nutritious mushroom. ₹500 for a strong seed. Oh, I need more rings. Huge apple. Right. One thing we'll get into a little bit later is the different coloured Chao. Basically, your Chao can take on a certain shape based on. Actually, let's get this planted first, then we'll talk about that. Don't remember how to plant it. They have to have a watering can or some shit. Let's leave it there for the moment. That one there. We will look back in on those a little later. But now, let's get bread. And let's feed him some fruit. We need to get that stamina up, because he's getting really good at swimming, but he has no stamina. So yeah, what I tend to do with the coloured Chao is, Chao can take on shapes based on the character who looks after them, the character who gives them attention. So we can make a Sonic Chao, we can make a Shadow Chao, and what I like to do is get the blue one and turn it into a Sonic one. It's that simple. What I'll do when I do that is I'll feed it on fruit and power cores only. There'll be no animals with that one. Just keep it like pure Sonic Chow. Okay, we need more fruit. God damn it, Chow, get back here. See, he's getting good at swimming now, so he wants to go in the water. When you get a Chow that gets good at flying, you'll find it keeps like climbing up here, and you'll find them randomly flying around the garden. Good Chow, I think we'll raise his stamina to level 3, and then we will go do some fight. He's making a run for it. Chow, eat fruit. Likes Sonic at the minute. That's why when you come into the Chow Garden, you get a choice of which hero you come in, because it can affect your Chow. What will happen if I give him the seed? Did we finish that? Have a seed. He's happy now. He's a happy Chow. Let's just put this out of the way for the moment. Let's finish feeding him this fruit and then we'll... Good Chow. Oh. No, eat the fruit. Eat the fruit or I will punish you. Eat your fruit. Gorge yourself, my Chow. Eat the fruit.
Don't worry, buddy.
I didn't mean to pet him. I wanted to punish him. And you're confused. Worry, good job. Okay, work it out. Work it out. Plant it for me, child. Plant it. The magic's happening. Chow is clever! Are you literally gonna go and like put it under another tree? It's like, oh, this is not a good place. I think this is a really good way of solving. Yeah. I'm sure this is how you plant it. So, yeah, this is a good spot. Chow. I'm just gonna leave that there for a sec and see if anything happens with it. Come on. Plant the fruit. Be a good Chow. It's not difficult. Not there. Not there. Be a clever Chow. Come on, be a clever Chow. Come on, be a clever Chow. Be a clever Chow. Come on, little buddy. I want to discuss the way I think the mechanics of this work, so get on with it. I wonder if I have to pet him when he gets to the exclamation mark.
Don't worry, buddy.
No, he just dropped it. Nope, you're not being useful. Plant the seed. Plant the seeds? Are we just awkward about where we plant seeds? Maybe the seeds have to plant themselves. Get back here, you ignorant git. There for a little while and see if they plant themselves. In the meantime, we'll carry on forging our chow on fruit. Okay, so basically the way I think it works is that the way I think the whole idea behind the chow moving the seeds around is that if you allowed the player to place trees wherever you like, you could have these collision issues and it would just look a complete mess. Like you can put two trees close together, you can put ones where they glitched out. By having seven fixed locations for trees, it allows the developers to skip a little bit of testing. But the thing is, if there's only like seven locations, how do they tell you where they are? And that's it. They get the chow to place it for you. Kind of feeling, do we need a watering can or something? I don't know whether it's just a matter of time or we need a watering can or what. It's been so long since I've played this game. Don't worry, buddy, it's not like I'm gonna throw you. Totally wouldn't do that. I wasn't even gonna go to level 3, but just to give these a little bit of time, I'm probably gonna go to level 4. They'll probably find that now I've actually bought a seed, there'll be a watering can in the black market, some shit like that. It's like, oh, have this, it's amazing, but we're not going to tell you. You can work out how to do it. We're not going to give you what you need, you have to come back later with more money. Okay, we're level 4. We're going to have a quick look in the black market to see if there's like a watering can or some shit. Okay, apparently not. Huh. And they're still not planted. Okay, let's go have some chow combat. Start with a race, I think. Do 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 do. Did we win? I think we won the beginner race last time, didn't we? Let's take Fred, because Fred is tough. Okay, so let's do all the level 1s first. Because we know Fred can pretty much monster the level 1s. Press A button to cheer your chow during the race. Yes, okay. I remember this one. Do 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 do. Come on, Fred. Mash A. There we go. Give him a little boost so he doesn't get stuck behind anyone. Because I have had chows that have massively higher stats. They have massively higher stats, but they sort of fall behind just out of random bad luck, and then they just get stuck. Is that it? Oh, that was easy. So that was kind of supposed to be a fly, but a fly answer. I think the idea is if you have good enough fly there, there is no swim. Maybe if I, like, hammered the A button, he would have made it all the way over. I don't know. And I'm probably not going to find out right now, because we're going to move on to the next race. I got to read, but I think this is the running one. Go on, Charles. Stop looking cheerful. Be serious, man. This is a serious race. Come on, Fred. I believe in you. Go, Fred. I'm gonna like use up a bit of his stamina just speeding this up. Yeah, this is just a running one. Yeah, stamina bar is going down, so you do have to be careful that you don't empty the stamina bar completely, or Fred will just sit there and ask for encouragement, which will lose the race. Awesome, go Fred. Go Fred. Right, one more. Forget which one we're missing now. I can't remember which one we did last time. Beginner race. Okay. Come on, Fred. Let's see what you do up to. Block Canyon, I think. This is strength. Yeah, compete in strength. This is going to be like climbing or some shit. Go! Come on, Fred. I believe in you. Go, Fred. I'm disgusted with you, Fred. You could have got that below 15 seconds easily. Easily. You're pathetic. Pathetic, Fred. And your head is shame. Okay, quick race. Let's try the fighting. Ciao, karate. Do we think Fred is ready for the high level tournaments yet? think he's... He's going to demolish the newborns, but... Chalski. The reason I licked my finger then is it's not some sort of pervy chow thing. If you get a wet finger using an Xbox 360 controller, you can rub your finger back and forth over the button, and you can do that to press the button really, really fast rather than just trying to like, hammer up and down. Right, we're nearly ready to pump. Perfect, hit him one more time. You can do it with a lot of other controllers, and you know, granted, you can. Some people can press the button really fast anyway. I was used to be pretty quick at this, but you can do it much faster than that, and much more consistently as well. Awesome! Kick Chowski's ass! Shaolin. Come on, Fred. You can do it. You can do it, Fred. Don't let that bitch hit you. Kick his ass. Fred, dodge it. Dodge his baby's sort of crawl hop. So Fred's got a lot more damage by the looks of it, but Shaolin has more speed. Are you ready, Fred? We're gonna snooze faster. We can snooze faster than Shaolin, Fred. Come on. You got this, Fred. You got this. Take kick his ass. If we get another hit in, we might be like almost ready to push him off the back. Come on, Fred, kick his ass. Yes, nice dodge, Fred, good job. It's so much nicer to have a name to cheer for, even if it was a terrible name that I couldn't think of one. I should probably name him after my cat or some shit. Trouble is I have 5 cats, so which one do I pick? You can do this, Fred. It's a newborn chow. You can use your peacock powers to defeat him. Fred. See, Fred's doing much more damage. So I think he's struggling a bit with his speed, but his power is a little disproportionate. Oh yes, I don't know what gives the dodge chance, but it does seem he has a good dodge chance. Oh, was that a crit? Did you crit, Fred? Good job, Fred. Go on, Fred, we can sleep faster. Awesome. Go on, Fred. Sleepy time. If you do that without licking your finger, you will get a friction burn. Or you'll just do badly. Come on. Murder Chowoko! Good job, Fred! You cry, Chowoko. You're a loser! Ooh, we get Eggy. Eggy, I think this is the version that gets a little bit significantly tougher. I mean, this guy's got like an eggshell on his head to hide under. Who'd be afraid of a like, broken eggshell? There's fucking Humpty Dumpty here. I'm not gonna be beaten by Humpty Dumpty. That's it, you kick his ass, Fred. I think this guy is pretty tough, but he's slow. I don't remember the details. Actually, before I do the next episode, I'm probably gonna look up some of the mechanics details behind these fights. Okay, ready? Gotta recover faster, or Eggy is gonna kick our ass. Dodge, Fred. Come on, Fred, you could have dodged that. We need a crit, Fred, come on. Or a dodge. Come on, one more hit, Fred. That's all we need. Come on, Fred. Fred, you pathetic. Better get that one hit in, I think, out of one on timeout. Okay, guys, I'm going to call the episode there. Thanks for watching. I will see you guys tomorrow. Bye-bye.